Okay, hi class, and so let me give you a tutorial here for the last question of assignment number 4, which is the FEA exercise, fatigue analysis, or the part that you have done in assignment number 2. So it's the same part, we can notch it here. Okay, so you have done a static FEA analysis, okay, so we're going to do a fatigue analysis. The material will be ASAISI 1045 curriculum, and the vertical load will be 28,000 newtons, so we'll modify this. So in assignments, I've given you two ways. One is for a quick fatigue study, okay, and the other one is for a food fatigue analysis. Okay. So we'll take a look at how we conduct this, and then we can compare with some of these results that we calculate the theoretical, okay? So let's come back to the SOLIDWORKS. Okay, so here's the parts that we have built. And basically, this is the static analysis that you have carried out, okay? The force has been changed, the material has been changed to 1045. So the mesh control here, as I mentioned in the class, you can apply a different mesh around this area, okay, just to fine and tune the FEA analysis. Okay. So for example, if I show the mesh right here, so you can see that the size of the elements right here, the mesh is much smaller and much finer than the other area. Okay. So you carry out this static analysis, okay, and you can see that the maximum Lorenzo stress is calculated to be 342 megapascals. Okay. So
now remember this
number here, and then we will be able to do some calculations. Okay. So the other thing is, let's take a look at the material here, and this 1045 steel, and you can see the tensile strength is here 625 megapascals. Now in our textbook, what we get here is actually 630. Okay, so it's a little bit different. The SOLIDWORKS give a little bit different result. And in the database, they use the different numbers. Okay, so now we're ready to do a fatigue analysis, but let's do a quick analysis first. So we'll click on the results, okay? And here, define fatigue check plot. Okay. So inside here, okay, first one, loading time, we're going to choose fully reverse loading. And this is a surface finishing, so you choose cold drawn. Okay. The number here is the surface finishing factor. This factor is SOLIDWORKS given. I'm not sure how to kind of calculate it, but that's different from what we learned in class. So you can see the surface factor for our case, cold drawn. Okay, you use the table and do the calculation, you'll see that it's actually 0.817. Okay. Now, so we can change that to 0.817. The loading factor is axial, according to what we learned, is actually 0.85, right? TC value. So I'm going to change that to 0.85. Okay. Here is the size factor, and the size factor uses axial loading. And it's actually axial loading. So now 7.5, if I remember correctly, that is for so axial loading, according to what we learned, actually because it's axial loading, so we're going to change that to 1. Okay? And P is actually 1. So that's the values you press enter. You can see that there's a cumulative factor. The cumulative factor, which is really the multiplication of three numbers in here. So you get this. The bottom here, there's material for this one here. It says fatigue strength, which is this much here. So basically, it's 312 megapascals. 312 megapascals, how do we get that? Actually, it's just 0.5 multiplied by the yield strength. Right? Remember the yield strength material I showed you? It's a 625 megapascals. So multiplied by 0.5, you get this.
Gotcha. So now what you can see here is actually it's already showing you, you can check mark, okay? It's already showing you the red area, okay, which is basically your the area which will have a fatigue failure, okay, due to the stress concentration,
right? So that's pretty good, and that's a very quick check there.
The other thing is that we ask what to specify here. If you click specify here, what you're doing here, you're actually just specifying a cumulative factor. The cumulative factor is 6, 9, some sort of 1, 5, 1, 4, 4, something like that, right? As we calculate it, okay? Yeah, a 4, 4, 5, okay? So that's the number you can, you know, put it over here, okay? So you'll get exactly the same results if you do that. So that's how you do a quick check for fatigue. So how do you do a full analysis of this?
Click study, okay, click on new study,
and click on fatigue. Okay. So give a name of that. You see, I'll just keep that as a new
fatigue test.
Okay. Here, the loading time here, the option here, choose a constant amplitude event.
Okay, so we're not dealing with this one as variable amplitudes. So we're not dealing with this one here.
Okay, so check mark. So now we're under fatigue analysis. So the working tree added here, right? So right, first of all, what you do is to add an event.
Right click on the loading, add event.
Choose the static, which is basically the one that you have static, the static one. But you only have one static case, so you just pick this one. This block here is a fully reversed, this is the loading time. And if you
click here, you see that you can have a zero base and a loading ratio. Zero based means you have a repeated type of loading, right? Mean value is zero. And for fully reversed, the mean value is the negative value, so that's why here is -1. Okay?
Here, the loading cycle here, you can get 1,000, actually, you'll find out it doesn't matter. But we're going to give 10 to the power 6 of the loading cycles. Check mark. Okay, so the next step. What you do is, and right click on it, and
to set some properties for this fatigue test.
Here, so there's some random interaction and dimension stats,
and the competing alternates, but alternating the stress,
we don't have to change that, just use this one here.
In the mean stress correction here,
we're going to choose the good one. Now, what does this mean is, if you recall in our lecture, we have calculated some sort of equivalent alternating stress, right, based on a combined loading, right? Basically, if you're combined loading here, what would be the equivalent to stress, right?
If you use Goodman here, you use Goodman line, you have to calculate the equivalent,
one means that the equivalent completed
the reversed stress. So that's what it means here, okay? Yeah, so the mean stress correction. Fatigue stress reduction factor, which is given 1. And the infant life here, so we're going to choose maybe 10 to the power 6, okay? And as infant life, okay, so this doesn't matter. This only affects the final plotting, actually.
Okay. So now click OK.
And you can't run a study yet, so you still have to do one more thing. Okay. Now this is to apply the stress and life diagram, the same diagram.
So right-click on this part here and apply edit fatigue data. Okay, so you can see that this material is selected. And over here there's
fatigue passing curve. And over
here there's a table of data basically shows your how the fatigue passing curve is constructed. We are going to take megapond here. Okay. So this is basically an Excel type of a table. You can modify each one of the cell. You know, the first column is the number of cycles to fill. The second column is the fatigue strains. Okay? So this much fatigue strains, you have this much filling. Okay? The interpolating basically means how do you interpolate between the two data points. Okay? So you can choose either log-log, okay, or you can choose linear.
Right?
And you can define actually different curves for the same material. Okay. So now what we notice is, what I notice is these
data points here are actually not quite precisely the same as the material here.
So the reason I'm talking about this here is, if you recall that how would you draw a S-N diagram is that you have to use that SF, right, equal to A N to the power of B, you know, that particular way to draw it. Right, so this is how you do that. Remember that? you have the material property, so you find out the fatigue fraction value from this figure that captures the A and B value. Then you can calculate basically SF equal to AM to the power of B. So what I did is I used MATLAB to do a little program here. So find the value for SUT, tensile material, the yield tensile strings, right? And plug in the calculated endurance limit. Right? The calculated endurance limit is calculated basically based on the surface factor like this. Right? And we also have fatigue, or we'll use this later. So this is your SUT, this is your SE, right? And find out this F value. Calculate A and B, set up a data file, and create the loop here, starting from the 1000 cycle, and calculate the fatigue strings at each instance. So my distance here is 50,000 as one step. Okay, so what I found is you can't use too many data points. Use too many data points, SolidWorks won't work. So anyhow, this is a data point you can calculate and create a data file called sn.dat. So I'm going to use that file here. So click on the file in here, and click on the file again, and go and look for the file that you created, and somehow it's here, so click open. So then, as you can see now, so this is the data points here, right? 10, 51,000, 101,000, like this. So click save, click OK, and it asks you for data to update a database. So you can pick one database yourself, basically, just to give a name, right? I already have one here, so let me just select that one. It can overwrite the original database. Just give a new name. So now, what we have here is this material with user-defined sn.1. So we're going to use -1 here, right, instead of color that, that's a complete reversed loading, right? So anyhow, that's what we have here, okay? Now, interpolating methods here, so I'm going to pick log-log interpolate, okay? Log-log interpolate. So basically interpolate between the two points using log-log, okay? Click apply and OK. Okay. So now you're ready to run the study, okay? So let's run it. Okay, so now we can see here is, okay, so I have two plots generated, and this is my life, which is interesting, which is what we're interested. Click here, show it, right, so I can see here that we see,
to match that, quick check, right, so your fatigue region is this.
The total life cycle here is maximum is 1 minute, which is what we define, right,
1 minute as an
infinite cycle. So the minimum number cycle here is 25,000 number cycles physically, right?
Yeah. So 2.5 multiplied by 10 to the power of 4. Okay, so that's the fading, basically. This is where it will fade. Okay. Now let's check if these numbers are right. Okay, and see if it makes sense.
A quick way of checking this is, let's see, go back to static.
Now, if you recall that the one missile stress calculated here, what it gives is 342. Okay, 342 right here. So, if I go back to my fatigue right here, okay, and basically, your
minimum number of cycles to fill, which is correspond to that maximum one missile stress over there, right?
So let's see if that's the number here. So I'm using the MATLAB here. Right? So what I'll do is I'll use this formula here. Right? A
multiplied by the number of cycle, right, power of B.
Okay. So what I have here is, right, so recall that what I have here is
2.5 multiplied by 10 to the power of 4.
And if I go to MATLAB here, right, so I plug in this number here, A and B that we have calculated. And then I got my fatigue strings, which is
354.
Okay. Yeah. So that's 354
megapascals. That's roughly. So this is pretty close to what the study math index, right? The static results is 342 megapascals. Okay, a little bit higher than that. Okay, yeah, for some other reasons, I'm not sure why it's higher than that. But anyhow, that's how the number of cycles you feel is calculated. And you can also take a look at the here. So basically, 340 or 350 is higher than this one here. So your feeding, number of feeding cycles will be between this 1,000 and 51,000. And how this being interpolated? It's being used in this log-log interpolate. If you use linear, choose linear here, you apply it and then do fatigue the study again, the number of cycles you feel actually will be different. Okay. And you can try that. Okay. Let's try that. So that'd be red and green. So it's actually higher. Okay. So I think we should choose the log log because that's how our curve is generated, right? So we choose that. We should go back and change that to log log. Good. Good. So that's what we get here. Okay, so now let's do a kind of a theoretical calculations here and see if this will make sense. You will see some discrepancies. Okay, so let's go back to here. This is what I do for theoretical calculation. So I need to calculate the stress basically to know what kind of stress at the notch area. And in assignment number one, you have calculated the stress contingency factor is 2.0. And what will be the fatigue stress factor, right? So we need to know the sensitivity factor Q, and Q is calculated with a Newton constant. Okay? And plugging the formula here, calculate the fatigue stress contingency factor, which is this. So this one multiplied by the nominal value, we get I got this one 306. So this is actually a little lower than a static. If you call the static analysis, the static is from SolidWorks is 340 something, right? Lower than that. It is lower than my theoretic calculation if I plug in this formula here to calculate number cycle to feel. I actually got, you know, here 7.6, right? Multiplied by 10 to the power 4 number cycle to feel. So the order seems okay, you know, 10 to the power 4. Right. Because of the difference here, this 306, SolidWorks is 342, so the actual number here is a little bit different from your FEE analysis. Okay. But there's still a pretty good match right here. Okay. All the point of doing this is basically your FEE analysis, you can trust that all the time. Okay. You can use that as a train, as a good reference. Okay. Whenever you can do a hand calculation, you need to do this. You know, that'll do a comparison here, you know, that'll help you in terms of design. Okay. For more complex complex system, if hand calculation is not possible, of course, you'll just have to rely on the FEE analysis. So anyhow, so that's basically what the procedures that you do to carry out fatigue analysis. For the damage here, let's show you the damage here. So, yeah, there's pretty big damage here, right? Yeah. I'm not sure what this means. Okay, so let me know if you have any questions, and we can talk about it. Okay, thank you.